Today, I will be discussing the connection between histamine intolerance and IBS. So histamine intolerance and irritable bowel syndrome, IBS, are two distinct yet interconnected conditions, both affecting the gastrointestinal system and sharing a complex relationship. Histamine is a naturally occurring compound in the body, playing a crucial role in the various physiological processes. However, some individuals experience histamine intolerance, a condition characterized by inability to adequately break down and metabolize histamine, leading to accumulation of histamine in the body. The link between histamine intolerance and IBS lies in the similarity of symptoms, which can aggravate the symptoms on both sides of the two conditions. Individuals with histamine intolerance often report digestive issues such as abdominal pain, bloating, and diarrhea, symptoms that align with those of IBS. Histamine is involved in the regulation of gastric acid and gut motility, and its imbalance can disrupt these processes, contributing to worsening of IBS symptoms. Histamine intolerance may be influenced by various factors, including genetics, reduced activity of histamine-degrading enzymes, and the consumption of histamine-rich foods or those that trigger histamine release. Certain foods, such as aged cheese, fermented products, and processed meats, can be high in histamine or stimulate its release, potentially triggering or worsening IBS symptoms for some individuals. I have made a full list of foods to avoid and foods to eat when suffering from histamine intolerance that you can check out in the video description below. And now to other causes behind histamine intolerance. Histamine intolerance and IBS may share a common ground in terms of altered gut microbiota. The gut microbiome plays a crucial role in the metabolism of histamine, and an imbalance in the microbial community can disrupt this process. Changes in gut microbiota composition have been implicated in both histamine intolerance and IBS, suggesting a potential interplay between the two conditions. The challenge lies in the overlap of symptoms, making it difficult to distinguish between histamine intolerance and IBS. The bidirectional relationship between histamine intolerance and IBS further complicates the clinical picture, as each condition may influence the severity and course of the other. Managing this interconnected relationship involves a multi-phased approach involving dietary modifications, including low histamine diet, and identification of trigger foods are often recommended. Probiotics may be beneficial in restoring a healthy gut microbiota, and antihistamines can help ease symptoms of histamine intolerance, but their effectiveness in the context of IBS varies. So we still have a lot to learn about this intricate connection between histamine intolerance and IBS to gain a comprehensive understanding of their interplay. However, the point of this video is that if you are suffering from irritable bowel syndrome, and on top of that experience symptoms of histamine intolerance, you should then additionally be considering a low histamine diet for at least 4 weeks period, combined with an appropriate IBS diet plan. If you would like to learn more about IBS diet and what is an appropriate IBS diet plan, then you should check out another video that I have done on best IBS diet options. I've put a link down below in the video description that you can go and check out. And remember, if you have any IBS or histamine related questions, you can drop it in the comment section below and I will answer you. Thanks for watching.